August 9, 19th Sunday in Ordinary Time. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. After he had fed the people, Jesus made the disciples get into the boat and precede him to the other side. While he dismissed the crowds, after doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them, walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." He said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately Jesus stretched out his hand and caught him and said to him, "O you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Trusting God. The prophet Elijah did not leave behind any writing, but the Jews considered him as the greatest prophet in the Old Testament. Elijah appeared with Moses at the transfiguration of Jesus on Mount Horeb. Until today, the Jews await the coming of a Messiah who will be preceded by Elijah. God entrusted Elijah with the difficult mission of bringing the people back to their faith. Most of them had abandoned God and started to worship Baal, an idol brought by the pagan princess Jezebel. Elijah declared a terrible drought that lasted for 3.5 years in punishment for the sins of the king and his people. The drought led to a terrible famine, and King Ahab relied on the prophet's intervention. Elijah engaged the priests of Baal to a challenge that they lost, resulting in their carnage. Stung to fury, Jezebel swore to have Elijah killed. The prophet fled to the desert and became a fugitive. Discouraged and exhausted, Elijah wanted to die. God sent him an angel with food and drink and commanded him to climb Mount Horeb. There, as the first reading tells us, God reveals himself to Elijah in a tiny whispering sound. The prophet does not find God in the strong and heavy wind. God speaks neither through the earthquake nor through the fire. The ways of God are gentle and quiet. God risks not being heard at all. God is found in every simple detail of life and not in spiritual pyrotechnics. God does not force us but allows us to make personal decisions. Neither does God frighten us, because God wants us to obey out of trust and love. Elijah regains the confidence in God's power and goodness. He is convinced that God is close to him, so he becomes determined to fulfill the mission entrusted to him. Peter in the Gospel also struggles with his faith in Jesus. When their boat is tossed in the lake by strong headwinds and Jesus walks on the water, Peter thinks that the human figure moving in the dark is a ghost. It does not cross his mind that Jesus, who has recently multiplied bread for the multitude, can indeed walk on the water. "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." Peter manages a few steps on the water but allows himself to be distracted by the strong wind and begins to sink. Jesus laments Peter's little faith. catches him and calms the water. The Apostle Paul in the second reading wrestles with the thought that his fellow Jews do not recognize Jesus as the Messiah. Paul is disturbed that the Jews, as God's chosen people, have rejected Jesus. Did God, perchance, regene on his promise? The apostle to the Gentiles ultimately trusts that God's plan will be fulfilled in God's mysterious ways.